Hello, bookers all over the world. I am back, and today I am doing my top 10 paranormal young adult books. So a lot of these books seem to fall into like the fantasy slash paranormal section. So I've kind of just put some out that I thought were higher fantasy and put some in that I thought was a little bit more paranormal than fantasy kind of thing. So some of you guys might be like, that's not paranormal, but in my eyes, it is. So let's just be cool and just enjoy my top 10 paranormal books. In 10th place, I have a book that is really close to my heart because it was one of those books that kind of introduced me into the world of young adult, and it was kind of an even place between Twilight and this one, but I think that I enjoyed this one more than Twilight. And if you recognize the cover from doing this, then you will know that in 10th place it is the book Fallen by Lauren Kate. And if you didn't guess what I was doing then, I was trying to reenact the cover, just like really badly done. So this book is like an ultimate love story between this girl on the front called Luce and an angel called Daniel, and the moment they make eye contact they have this connection, and it's just this huge four book series of this romance between them, and it's crazy, and it's just, yeah, it's a good book. I read it, and if you guys love romances and paranormal then you have to pick it up and read it. It's also going to be a movie soon. I'm not sure how the movie's going to go, but let's hope it goes well because I'm interested to see what they do with it. So this next one is one that I expected the least from, but I actually enjoyed it because I had really low expectations. And that one is The Coldest Girl in Coldtown by Holly Black. I had a few of my friends who said that this was going to be a really bad book, so I kind of thought, oh, I'm going to read it because I got it on my TV Red shelf. And then I started reading it and I really enjoyed it. I don't see why it has like a few bad reviews. I gave a pretty high review because, yeah, I liked it. In this, there's a place called Coldtown, which is basically where all these like vampires live, and they're like really rich and have these great parties and eat humans all the time and stuff like that. And this human girl Tana decides that she's gonna go to Coldtown, and basically all hell breaks loose. But seriously, the start of this book had me absolutely trapped because it starts with this really crazy scene and you're just hooked from the very first page. 7th place is Switch by Amanda Hocking. This is another one of those books that I read ages ago and it just kind of holds place in my heart. It's one of the only series that I've managed to reread, which that's something great. It also has a new spin-off series that's going on right now called Frostfire, which I don't enjoy that nowhere near as much as I enjoyed Switch because this was like amazing in comparison. So this is about trolls. A girl called Wendy finds out that she was a changeling and that these people are after her because there's a bad group of people who wants to steal all these baby trolls, and then there's the good people, and she basically returns to her family and finds out that she's a princess. And she's trying to get along with doing the life there while it's also in the middle of a war, and it's crazy and good and the characters are amazing and I really liked it. So this next one is by one of my all-time favourite authors. She's pretty hilarious on Twitter, and that is Maggie Sitefvater, and this is her Shiver series, which is The Wolves of Mercy Falls. So this is like a werewolf series where the wolves change form due to climate change, which is pretty awesome, and it features on two main characters called Grace and Sam, and Sam is a werewolf, whereas Grace is just a human, and basically it's their story, and I absolutely love it. It's such a cute little romance book. At the same time, it's got a lot of adventure and a lot of amazing characters. Like the characters that I absolutely love, from the side characters and the main characters, it's just awesome. And this is a series that absolutely everybody loves, and that is Vampire Academy by Richelle Mead. And this has just become a movie, and I'm pretty sure that everyone who saw it thinks it's just that bad, but the series is so good. I absolutely loved it, and I would recommend it to anyone who likes paranormal romances slash adventures and kick-ass female characters like Rose Hathaway, who is just amazing. Like, I love her. Book number 5 recently, and I absolutely love the first book in the series. As a series as a whole, I didn't like it that much, but the first book was amazing, and that is A Great and Terrible Beauty by Libba, Bray. And this was on my TV Red pile for so long, and I finally read it on holiday and I was blown away by it. The book is set in 1895 after the main character Gemma Doyle's mother was murdered, and she basically gets sent to London to go to Spencer Academy, where she gets to learn to be a lady. And then she finds out that she holds magic abilities, and her friends at school find out, and they can go to this like other world, and it's amazing, and it's definitely going to be filled with a lot of suspense and action and drama that you don't expect to happen at Spence Academy. Fourth place. There's an author that has already been seen on this list, but she's pretty much like the queen of paranormal, and that is Bloodlines, which is the spin-off series of Vampire Academy by Richelle Mead. And I actually liked the series more than I liked Vampire Academy, and I've lost a tooth. So the dentist fixed it. Everyone on the front here at Sydney would be so petrified of me right now, because she is an alchemist, and this is Adrian, who is one of the characters from the other books, and he's a vampire, but alchemists don't like vampires. But Sydney gets punished for doing something bad in the Vampire Academy series that I can't spoil, and she basically has to go and look after a royal vampire, and that royal vampire has a little entourage with Adrian and Eddie, who are a bunch of Maroi and a bunch of other people, and it's just like this adventure and funny and crazy story that goes on between all of them. And I just really love the series more than the other one, especially the start of the series. The end of it isn't that great, but like I said, yeah, the start's really good and the characters are just like extra amazing in this one. So you should definitely pick this up as well if you've read the Vampire Academy series, or, you know, if you guys like paranormal. This is where it starts to get heated up. This is where like the fangs and the claws come out, because it is the top three. And do you guys know what my top three is going to be? Well, you're going to find out. Third place, a very debatable book to some people, is The Clockwork Angel by Cassandra Clare, and I absolutely love this series. I love the time it's set in, I love the whole Shadowhunters theme, the characters, even the stupid love triangle that they have in this book. I absolutely love it because the characters, you know, Will, Tessa and Jem, kind of like the adventures that happens with them, and it's just these crazy villains and them just trying to work through all these issues. I've only just noticed now that like my top two books are like the most chilling, scary ones out of the whole pile. And that's probably because I like that kind of stuff. In second place, we have Angelfall by Suzanne Ng. This book basically features these really badass angels that are taking over the world, and it's like a dystopia kind of cross paranormal, and this girl Penryn watches her sister get stolen by these bad angels, and so Penryn decides it's going to be her mission to go and rescue her sister. And at the same time, she's also found this angel who's had his wings cut off, and they kind of help each other to help each other. It's like a really sick and twisted storyline, and it's also really amazing at the same time, but it's definitely one that I gave 5 stars to, and the series has just been completed, so now would be a really good time to read a really dark paranormal, then pick up this one. And in first place, we have... Anna Dressed in Blood by Kendare Blake. This book is about ghosts, and not just like plain haunting ghosts that wear like white blankets over their heads, but ghosts that haunt a house that when a human walks into it, they literally rip their bodies in half. And that's Anna. Anna's actually a really nice ghost, but you know, people say that she's bad, but you know, she just has a few minor problems like being dead and stuff. And a ghost killer called Kaz comes into her life after hearing about these tales about how Anna is killing these teenagers who invited the house, and he basically walks in there and she doesn't kill him, which is like the first person she's never killed, because it's kind of like a reaction thing, and they become friends pretty quickly, but he has to choose between being her friend or having to actually kill her. But there is bigger problems stirring in the town that Anna and Kaz live in. Definitely worth a read. It is a duology. It's got twists that you won't see coming, and the storyline's great, and so are the characters. You guys will really enjoy it if you pick it up. It's also pretty dark, twisted, and scary. So if you guys are into that kind of stuff, you little freaks, then definitely read it. It's good. One of the trends that I've discovered after piling up these paranormal books is that there's only one out of my top 10 that isn't a dark color. And then I looked at my shelf and saw other paranormal books that I read, and why are they always dark? They're trying to be scary and mysterious, and they're accomplishing that because these are all very scary and mysterious. So there you have my top 10 paranormal young adult books, and I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. Be careful of vampires, they always out at night and they might suck your blood and that can really take away the fun from going to go and buy these books, so you know, just be careful. Thank you for watching and I hope you guys all have a good day/night wherever you are. Happy reading!